This video will show you how to make a multiphase diffusion simulation using the graphical mode version of the Diffusion Module, also known as DICTRA. This example is about the carburization of a nickel-chromium alloy. This is modeled as a multiphase region with M7C3 and M3C2 carbides in an FCC-A1 matrix using an activity condition for carbon at the left boundary. The calculation is based on Diffusion Module Example 7, which can be accessed from within Thermo-Calc in the Help menu, Open Examples, Diffusion Module DICTRA. If you want to run the example as it is, double-click on the example file, then right-click on the top node, and select Perform Now. Beginning with Thermo-Calc 2017B, the Diffusion Module will run calculations with up to 3 elements, even if you do not have a Diffusion Module license, meaning that all users can now run all of the Diffusion Module examples using the demo version. You can learn more about this calculation by going to our online help system. The program opens in an internet browser, but the files are stored locally on your computer, so you do not need an internet connection to use it. From the main menu, go to Diffusion Module, Examples, Graphical Mode, Descriptions, and scroll to Example D7. To begin the calculation, click on the Diffusion Module template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. All the nodes we need to run a diffusion simulation will appear in the project pane. From the Database Package menu, select the Demo Steels and Fe Alloys Database Package, which will load both the thermodynamic and mobility demo databases. Select the elements nickel, chromium, and carbon. Next, select the Diffusion Calculator node, which opens the Diffusion Module. We will accept the default values for the top section. Name the region austenite and set the width to 0.003 meters. Set the points to 100 and the type to geometric with a ratio of 1.02 in order to have more grid points close to the left boundary. Beginning with Thermo-Calc 2017B, when you hover your mouse over a region, a tooltip appears showing the name of the region, the width of the region, and the number of grid points, which is especially helpful when you have more than one region. Next, add 2 more phases and set the phases to FCC-A1, M7C3, and M3C2. There are several ways to calculate the effective diffusivity through the multiphase mixture, so we must select a homogenization function that best corresponds to the microstructure we have. To do this, click on the Options tab. Under the Homogenization Model Specific section, click on the Homogenization Function drop-down menu. If you are familiar with the console mode, you may recognize that there are more functions available there. These will be added to the graphical mode in 2018. Select General Upper Hoschen-Strickmann Bound. The geometrical interpretation of the Hoschen-Strickmann bounds are concentric spherical shells of each phase. Please be aware that this represents an upper bound. To learn more about this, go to our online help system and search for homogenization functions. Return to the Conditions tab and select Edit next to Composition Profiles. Beginning with Thermo-Calc 2017B, the initial composition profiles are visualized directly when you enter them. You now have 3 options, and when you hover your mouse over the drop-down menu, a useful tooltip explains what each of the 3 does. We will leave both as linear. Next, we will set the composition of the alloy. Set chromium from 25 to 25, and carbon from 1e to the negative 4 to 1e to the negative 4. Notice that when we do this, the components are visualized in a simple plot. Select Apply. If you are using Thermo-Calc 2017B or newer, you will notice that there is a new section in the Diffusion Module where you can define the left and right boundary conditions, which allows you to fix the activity or composition for each boundary. There are 2 new options, and in this video, we'll select Mixed Zero Flux and Activity for the left boundary condition. Chromium is not allowed to enter or leave the system, so we will leave it at zero flux. We want to set a carbon activity boundary condition where the activity should be given with graphite as a reference state, So we will set carbon to activity 1.0. If we hover our mouse over activity, a tooltip appears telling us that the reference states for the components are defined in the System Definer on the Components tab. So return to the System Definer and select Components tab. We will accept the defaults for nickel and chromium. Uncheck the box next to carbon and set the reference state to graphite. Then return to the Diffusion Module. Set the temperature to 1,123 Kelvin and the simulation time to 1,000 hours. Our calculation is now set, but we must configure the plot, so click on the Plot Renderer node. Under the X-axis, uncheck the box next to Automatic Scaling and set the limits from 0 to 0.002, stepping at 5e to the negative 4. Now click Perform at the bottom center of the program. This plot shows the composition of carbon as a function of distance after 1,000 hours, or 3,600,000 seconds. And we can see that carbon diffuses into the material. If you run the example file included in your software, this plot will also include experimental data. Let's set up one more plot. Right-click on the Plot Renderer node and select Clone. Beginning with Thermo-Calc 2017b, a new advanced mode was added to the Diffusion module, which allows users to plot additional combinations of axes. Before the addition, users had a limited number of combinations to choose from. But now, if you select Switch to Advanced Mode, you gain access to many new options. Let's plot the phase fraction as a function of distance. So select Phase Fraction. Uncheck the Automatic Scaling box and set the limits from 0 to 0.4, stepping at 0.05. Now select Perform again. The plot shows us the phase fraction as a function of distance. We can see that M3C2 carbide forms closer to the surface where the carbon content is high, and that M7C3 carbide forms further in the material where the carbon content is lower. Users can now also plot user-defined functions, giving you a lot of flexibility in the plotting. Simply select User-Defined from the Y-axis variable drop-down menu and enter the function in the text box to the right of the drop-down menu. For example, you can enter ACR, parentheses, C, and paren to plot the activity of carbon with graphite as the defined reference state. Check the Automatic Scaling box to get a better view in the plot, then click Perform to see the results. To learn about how to define functions using console mode syntax in the Thermo-Calc and DICTRA quantities, see our online help system. Search for set_diagram_axis. Finally, beginning with Thermo-Calc 2017b, the Diffusion module now has a table renderer. Right-click on the Diffusion Calculator node, highlight Create New Successor, and select Table Renderer. Then right-click on the Table Renderer node and select Perform Now. Your table will appear in the results pane alongside the plots. We hope you find this example useful. You can learn more about the Diffusion module and other calculation types by watching additional videos on our website at www.thermocalc.com or by clicking the links currently on your screen.